This is going to be a quick video to show you how to connect your dry contact to a remote starter on a generator using both a generator controller, which in this case I'm using smart gen. Any simple generator controller will do this. So basically I have the dry contacts that's coming from the inverter feeding into the generator controller. To set up the generator controller, you have six lines going from here to the generator. One line is the battery positive, battery negative, generator start signal or starter signal, kill switch signal, and then you have two feedback from the generator with 120 volt into the controller for the controller to know that the generator started. So those are the six terminals that come from generator, from between the generator and the controller. Now, in parallel to that, I took the dry contacts here and I split them, and I added another bypass for the dry contacts connected to a Wi-Fi internet-based smart switch. So it's by Tuya, and you download the app, and this is what the app looks like. Called Tuya Smart, and then that's what happens. You have the generator start and stop. So you have the generator start and stop. So what happens is when I push this button, it will close. This is connected normally open. So you have in each of the terminals here, you have the COM, and then normally open or normally closed. This is connected to the normally open. So in normal case, this circuit is open. Those two wires, which is the brown and the white, they're not connected right now, but which simulates the dry contacts that comes from the inverter. So you get the two, the yellow and the brown are connected to the normally open. So in normal condition, the signal comes from the inverter, the circuit will close. Same thing on this one. If I give it a signal to start, it would be closing this circuit, and that will give the signal, which we call it remote signal, to the smart gen controller, which is, like I said, you can pick any controller will do the same function. So right now, as you can see, the generator is stopped. And right now I'm gonna push that button, and that button will act as a relay here, and it will start the generator. It will give the signal to the generator controller as a remote signal. So I'm gonna demo this for you. You heard the signal. Now the generator controller is going through its startup procedure, which waits 2 seconds, then send the signal to the starter. You hear the generator kicked in, and after 3 seconds it disconnects the starter, and now we have voltage. So we have 126 volts coming from the generator, everything is supporting. As you can see on my inverter here, the inverter is showing that I have utility coming, which is that sign right here. So this is the utility. So I have solar, I have utility, the battery is charging. My battery is 100%, so I'm not really putting anything on towards the charger, toward charging the battery. It's only supporting the load in the house. So what I'm gonna do is, right now this thing is still on, this switch is still on. So I'm gonna turn it off now. And once I turn it off, the generator controller will sense that, hey, I don't need the generator anymore. So it will go into the shutdown sequence. So follow with me and listen to the relay here. Now the signal came to the generator controller to stop the generator. So it's going through the shutdown sequence. In this case, I have it, I think, at 8 seconds, and then it will do the kill switch. There you go. And toggle switch will stay open until the generator fully stops and it will disconnect. This is about it, and if you have any questions, send me a comment and I will be able to reply to help you out. So this is how you connect your inverter generator on a remote controlled using Wi-Fi, and you can turn it on and off from anywhere in the world. Thank you. Have a good day.